Hello friends, welcome. Yesterday I made a video about natural healers, who's quite natural to it, or how we can develop it. And you know, I said the best way to channel healing is with love and compassion, because it is the strongest force of healing that there is, if you give it with love and for the person's needs, and you always give it with the hope that it might cure that whatever their problem is. Sometimes it does, sometimes it doesn't. So anyway, I went to the church last night to the clairvoyant service, and the medium, he gave a reading so before he did his clairvoyance. And I'd like to just share that story as best I can. I have short-term memory loss, so I forget bits of it. But anyway, this is the story as far as it goes, because it was a story of compassion and love and goodwill. So anyway, there was this lady that had broken down on the side of the road, and it was a wet and cold night. She'd been stood out in the rain and cold for an hour, when eventually a car stopped and a man got out and started walking across to her, who'd seen she was broken down, and his name was Brian Adam. And he went across, and the woman was fearful because nobody stopped for an hour, and she was on her own in the middle of nowhere. And he could see that, and he said, "Don't worry, no harm will come to you. Go get in your car in the warm and dry, and I'll fix your car for you." And it had a puncture, and anyway, he fixed the car, and it had a put the new wheel on, and he skinned his knuckles in the process of doing it a couple of times. And when he finished, the lady got out, and she went to give him some money, and he wouldn't take it, because all his life he had been a giving person and wouldn't take nothing. It was out of goodwill and compassion for his fellow human beings. So anyway, he wouldn't take the money, and he said, "But don't break the chain. Pass this goodwill, this love, on to somebody else." And anyway, he watched her on her way to make sure she got off all right. And you know, he was cold and hungry himself, and wet, and so anyway, he went home, and she went a little further down the road, the lady that had broken down, and she got to a roadside cafe, and she was wet and cold, so she decided to pull in and have a hot drink and something to eat. And she went into the cafe, and there was a waitress there that was quite heavily pregnant, and she came across to the lady, and she could see she was wet and cold, so the waitress got her a towel to dry her hair, and the lady put her order in, and she brought her a hot drink and bits and pieces. And, you know, the lady thought this waitress was uncomplaining, having been on her feet all day, heavily pregnant, and, you know, was a very friendly and loving person. And she sat there and had her tea and something to eat, and she gave the waitress a £50 note when she went to pay. This was a rich woman, you know, she had lots of money. And anyway, when the waitress came back, the lady had gone, had left. So she went to clear the table, and under the plate she found another £450 notes, and you know, a little note on there that said, "Please accept this, you know, and it's out of goodwill and love, but please don't break the chain. Pass this love and goodwill on to somebody else." And anyway, the waitress finished her shift late at night, and she went home, and she got into bed next to her husband, and she just went across to her husband, just kissed him lightly on the back, and said, "Don't worry, our problems are over, Brian Adam." So I thought that was a beautiful story, and it brought me out in goosebumps, that one. So it was a, you know, what you put out there to me is what you receive back. So, you know, it's maybe the law of nature, karma, whatever it is, that if you put out something good, you receive something good in return. And of course, the opposite, you put out negativity, that you get negativity in return. So, you know, that's the laws that operate sometimes, whereby, you know, you do a good service for another, it comes back to you. So, yeah, it's good to be loving and compassionate. I mean, I try to do my bit when I go out. I mean, I see sometimes some homeless people on the street and give them some change, or you know, in the charity boxes. But you know, I've had a man in a wheelchair just up the road from me, and I found him twice broken down, run out of battery in his electric wheelchair, and I've pushed him into his flat in his home, you know, which he wasn't far from anyway. But one time he was just sat in the middle of the road, and you know, he was like this, trying to get his wheelchair off the road, and you know, I was 100 yards away, and there was a couple of people, and a car stopped and just sat there and did nothing, you know, the person, and a couple of other people just walked blindly by, totally not taking any notice, ignoring him. So I run up the road and, you know, pushed him off the road and into his flat, you know. So to reach out to people that are in need is a good thing to do. And, you know, I'm not religious, but I've heard the bit in the Bible about the Good Samaritan, which is not such a different story to the one I just told, that the Good Samaritan was going through a town on his travels and he noticed a very sickly man and he took him into an inn and he paid for him to stay there until he was better. So, you know, it's just reaching out to other human beings. Sometimes I think we've become so remote and isolated sometimes to the plight of others, to the needs of others, to cut ourselves off from the world sometimes. And if this world's to become a better place, then it's up to us as individuals to do our bit to make it a better place, because people power is what changes this world. So yes, if we could be a bit more thoughtful, a bit more understanding of the needs that are less fortunate than of those that are less fortunate than ourselves, it could greatly help this world to be a better place. And you know, it's not always those that we immediately come across, is it? I mean, there's people in this world that are going through terrible things, civil wars and starvation, and you know, it's good to be that compassionate and loving person and care for other people, you know. And if you have the opportunity, you know, to help somebody else, then, you know, the law of nature or karma or whatever you like to call that redresses the balance that what you put out, so you shall receive. So anyway, I just wanted to tell that story. I hope you've enjoyed this. I wanted to share that. So love and light to you. Shep.